Pressed.
Here we go. Yep, good to go. Sleep time's over. Kevin the Catalyst. DJ Zach Morris. I'm in the devil's power to the corpus now. Put on Messiah, I set the microphone on fire. When I stab Scary, I carry like Mariah. I come from the Shaolin slum, and the Allah bomb is gonna do it now. Sleep time's over. Season 4, episode 4.
The Wu-Tang episode.
Woo! One thing I liked about Wu-Tang, the edited versions are just as good as the...
Correct, as the real versions,
real versions.
Swearing.
Because they all the colorful songs.
Yes, they did it right. Timberland win, yeah. Me and the clan and
all the land cruisers out there. Beast of all the crooks, all the niggas were bad. That's what you gotta do, kid. If you guys ever listen to Wu-Tang,
yeah, you gotta put your hands and do these things.
Just go in the mirror, send Wu-Tang up to 10.
Sorry.
You just gotta do those.
Like you're fidgeting. You're fidgeting.
Yeah. Fidget, fidget spinners.
Like a batu, maybe.
Yeah, just, whoa, I never experienced
it. Okay. Neither have I. Because remember, we never tried it.
Yeah. Not even once, bro.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. The Mystery of Chess Boxing.
Yes.
Is the name of the song.
Rest in peace to Old Dirty Bastard.
Old Dirty Bastard, a.k.a. Dirk McGirt.
A.k.a. Osiris, a.k.a.
A-Song. No, not A-Song.
A-Song
is
Unique.
A-Song is Risen.
Yeah.
Right.
AKA Big Baby Jesus.
Yes.
Yep. ODB.
Yep.
Yeah.
Many things. Many.
So Wu-Tang, we have to flip the switch on this one. We had something else planned for the show.
Yeah.
But since it is International Wu-Tang Day, we decided to do it for one of our favorite groups.
There you go.
Yours and mine's Wu-Tang Clan coming from Staten Island.
Yes.
Shaolin.
That's right.
How about we do a little, when did you first hear about Wu-Tang? Remember your first experience? With Wu-Tang Clan.
Yeah. It was, well, okay, if we really want to go back in the day.
Right.
The Genius, as he was known,
right,
before he became the GZA,
yes,
had an album called Words from the Genius.
Right.
And it was on Cold Chillin' Records. This was in 1990, I want to say.
89, 90.
89, 90. And it sucked.
Yeah, it wasn't that good.
And I bought it, and I was thinking,
but who is this
guy? Yes. And it was a song, they had like weird songs on there, like about like love and...
Yeah, really
there was
soft.
Some, you try to do me. He had some song in there that was like horrible. I'm like, what is this crap?
Yeah.
And then you had Prince Rakim,
yeah,
aka the RZA.
Yeah.
He came out, and then they had this song, We Love You, Rakim.
Love you, Rakim.
I love you too. Yeah, I love you too, baby. I mean, what is this rubbish? And who'd have thought that those same guys in the unsigned hype,
yeah,
on Source magazine, where they would focus on guys that were just coming out, like Notorious B.I.G., they had a song called Protect Your Neck.
Right.
And it was a very raw version of Protect Your Neck.
Yeah.
And it's pretty much epitomized the whole New York rough sound that was missing. And from the get-go, I loved it. It was just crazy, because you never heard all these guys rapping. I mean, Protect Your Neck was the official, even though I heard Genius and RZA.
Right. Was that the first single dropped?
Protect Your Neck. It was that. B-side was Method Man.
Right.
Yeah.
But the first video. Wait. Did they play Protect Your Neck first or Method Man?
Because
I think I.
Because they both had low budget videos for both songs.
Yeah.
Like they never showed the Method Man video, the original Method Man video. It was very low budget.
Right. I do remember seeing it on Yo though.
It was very low budget. And that's not the one, keep in mind, the one that where he's like out standing on rocks in a warehouse.
Okay.
That's the upgraded, we got money now, Method Man video.
Whoa.
There was another one where it's in black and white, and he's standing in just in black of a white screen.
Oh, I did not see that.
And then when he goes,
one.
Yo, I got myself a shorty, and then some girl comes out, and he goes, I got a shorty, and then every time he says something, something comes into the middle.
You know, I didn't even see that one.
That was an old, $20 Method Man video.
That's
you
crazy.
You probably find it, but I remember that was the first song,
right?
Protect Your Neck.
I remember seeing the Protect Your Neck video.
Yes.
That's actually, I'm thinking that was my first experience.
Okay. Okay.
I remember reading about him.
Yeah.
And then I seen the video.
Yeah.
Because Yo TV Raps is huge.
Yes.
Plus and Hoy.
Yes.
Seen the video. Who's these guys with no faces? Ghostface Killer.
Yeah.
Rapping any kind of Kung Fu.
Yeah, Kung Fu.
Hooked.
It sounded, I mean, it you got to just really get into it, because it could sound cheesy at first if you tell that to somebody. What is this, Wu-Tang Clan?
Yeah.
It just sounds lame.
Yeah. But, 8 black dudes.
Right.
From New York.
Yeah.
Are Chinese now.
Yeah.
But it's funny because no one ever questioned it.
Nope, they did not.
I never heard one like Asian Chinese dude be like, yo, who are these black dudes thinking that they're Chinese? Right. Everybody's right. Just like, yes.
Everyone's into it.
Wu-Tang Clan.
And they were serious about it. It wasn't a gimmick.
Yeah.
They lived that life. If you remember, you don't do your raps where they came on for the first time. Ed Lover pretended to be Hong Kong Fui.
Yeah.
And he became this Wu-Tang Chinese guy, and he had this weird wig on, and then RZA just slapped the wig right off his face.
Oh, I remember that.
And then everyone was laughing, and then RZA, like, pretty much like, shut up.
Wow.
I will never forget that. Like, and then Ed Lover was just like, oh, okay.
RZA,
but they kept that in the show. They didn't edit that out.
Nice. Ed Lover kept his composure, though.
He kept his composure,
yeah. There you go. Shout out to Ed.
Because they know how to act. They know. That's why they're a great host.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Because Ed Lover, you ever hear his interviews?
Oh yeah, it's great.
He's kind of a thug.
Yes.
It's amazing because you think he's a goofy old dude, Ed Two-Legger, peace to the brother with two.
He knows what he's doing.
Yeah, he's a real hip hop head.
He's a great interviewer.
Definitely a thug.
Lots of stories.
The best interview of Ed Lover.
Combat
Jack.
Yeah.
Great interview.
Incredible.
Great interview. Look, there's Dean right there with a slick haircut.
He's hungover from that Roosevelt party.
He was there, bro. Him, Bruno Mars.
Yep.
Chad Owens.
Sigh. Everybody. Gangnam Style was performed live, bro.
All over there. Anyway.
Okay, so yeah.
So we're doing this because we're doing a Mount Rushmore.
Of Wu-Tang members. Keep it simple.
Simple.
There's a million different Mount Rushmores you can get Wu-Tang.
Yes.
But
members.
Keep it simple, yes.
So are we doing a 1, 2, 3, 4?
Yeah, I wouldn't put this in any order.
No order, just our top four.
Your rocks. The rocks, the faces.
You want to go first or go first?
Go first. You go first.
Okay, here we go. This one is an easy one.
Right.
It was the B-side, and I'm going to go with Yours and Mine's M-E-T-H-O-D. Man.
You have to.
Method Man, bro. He needs to be on there.
You have to.
He was probably the figurehead, the face of Wu-Tang.
Yeah.
And when I did hear that track, Method Man, I was like, dude, amazing.
You know how we reference?
You get off my club.
Exactly, that song is classic.
He had that style too. We talked about that.
Yeah.
A lot of rappers, as being an MC,
you're
not trying to like breathe in the mic.
Yeah.
You're not trying to like hear anybody hear your. But he was all, hey,
he made that part of the show. Exactly.
Tecal, which I still don't know what that means to this day.
Isn't that like cannabis?
Is that Tecal cannabis?
I don't know. We gotta talk
about
that.
I thought it was just like, so, you know, same thing, you know? Like it's Wu-Tang isms.
Right. You got, I don't know.
So, represent, right?
Yippee-ya, yippee-ya, yippee-yo. I mean, Method Man has to be in there. Like, we referenced a concert that we both went to several weeks ago called Living Legends.
Yes.
And when we were going to Living Legends, a prominent member was named Murs. And we said, Murs not being at the Living Legends is like Method Man not being there for Wu-Tang.
That is true.
This is the equivalent of what this is. Okay, Method Man is the Mecca of Wu-Tang. Yeah. He is the heart and soul, the most famous
Wu-Tang
member.
Yeah.
I mean, RZA could be debated, but I mean, Method Man for his movies, his personality, he's out there.
His collabs.
Yes. I gotta say he's the most.
Okay, which collab was bigger? Him and Mary or Dirt Dog and Mariah?
For the hip-hop purists, it would be Method Man and Mary.
Right.
For the party people and for whatnot.
New York in the house.
And how smart is Old Dirty Bastard? I mean, granted, he probably had a good manager.
Yeah.
But to put Old Dirty Bastard on a song with Mariah Carey.
Yeah.
Now, if you go back to 1992 when this song came out.
Right.
Who would have saw that?
Who would have saw that?
Protect Your Neck with a guy named Old Dirty Bastard.
Yeah.
A person named Old Dirty Bastard. That's his official stage name to be with Mariah Carey.
Yeah. Nobody would have thought.
Amazing. Amazing.
And then Old Dirty Bastard and Maya?
Yep. And then he did Got Your Money?
Yeah.
Which was a major club hit.
Kellis?
Yes.
This is crazy. ODB works probably the best with females.
Yeah. It's like, a good offshoot because of his voice.
And he's different, right? He's like weird, zany.
So I think, the real hip hop heads love Your Own Need.
Yeah.
And Mariah, Old Dirty Bastard would be like the clubbers.
But for
the fact that Old Dirty Bastard, the smartest one though. Because of his marketing. Because of getting in where he fit in with people like Mariah Carey.
That's true.
I mean, he was smart.
For some reason, I think Old Dirty Bastard is more of Like maybe Method Man is the more mainstream one.
Yeah.
The face, you know.
Yeah.
Acting. He's a really good actor. I really like his acting.
Yeah.
You know, and but I think ODB might have been the one that the ravers like.
Yes.
You know what I mean? For some reason, a lot of these, when I did raves, a lot of these raver kids knew ODB.
Right. Because, well, how many people like it because of his name, first of all? You're going to hear a guy named Old Dirty Bastard. You're going to think, hey, what's up, bro? Who's this guy? Well, radical. Guy? And then from there, he's got this crazy voice. Radical. Like, okay, tubular. And then you go from there. So you have to put him, and that segues into Method Man's in there. Old Dirty Bastard got to be in there.
Yeah, number two, bro.
He's got to be in there.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm with you on both of these.
Yeah.
So those would be the two.
Old Dirty Bastard got in trouble for showing his EBT card, right?
Yeah.
And he literally had a platinum album on.
Yep. He was drunk on stage at the MTV Awards.
Yeah.
Where he came on. He was, when they were performing Ghetto Superstar, he was supposed to get out of the way because of this explosion. Proz had to push him out of the way because if he would have stayed where he was, the pyro was going to go up. Wow. He would blow up and then Old Dirty Bastard blow up.
Would have died earlier.
He would have, yeah, he would have blown up literally.
But he the one that like coined the whole Wu-Tang for the children.
Yes. Yes.
That's
yes.
Awesome.
But he was as real as it got. He was really like that guy, that crazy guy you know from around the way.
Yeah.
That you don't know what he does for a living. You don't know how he exists. But he's nuts. But yet he's fun at the same time. That's something. You know?
Yeah. So like Jamal. Like Jamal, bro.
I mean, yeah.
We need to get Jamal on this show.
That's going to be a 10-hour show.
And do a Jamal episode.
Who knows what
he is. Kilowatts the Mongoose.
Yeah, Kilowatts the Mongoose episode.
Quadrophonics.
Tof.
Wow. All that stuff.
Yep.
So we had Method Man.
Old Dirty Bastard.
We had Old Dirty Bastard. Two more faces.
Yep.
Who you got? Ghetto Superstar.
Right. One that has, in the beginning, if you told me in 1993 the name of him, I wouldn't put him on there, but okay. If you fast forward to now, I have to put him on Ghostface Killah.
Oh, nice.
You got to put Ghostface Killah now.
Ghostface Killah.
Because look at how his career has evolved.
Yeah.
Where he was wearing a mask.
Dude.
In the back of the day.
Yes.
And then he moved into, he's one of the only guys still relevant to this day.
Yeah, that's very true.
He's
man.
Still hanging in there. He could go to Republic and have a concert solo.
Yeah.
And it would probably draw a good size
that's
amount
right.
of crowd.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He's got to be up there.
He did constant reinvention of himself.
Yes.
I mean, his recent album with the live band,
right.
bad, not good.
Right.
Great album.
Yes,
also with
that.
Adrian Young.
Right.
12 Reasons to Die.
Right.
He also had, what was that song? Someone drilling or something.
There's
he also had, sorry about that. Sorry guys. They're drilling.
We got drilling.
He also
on,
had
man.
A bunch of other things. What am I doing with this? Theodore Unit. He had his own little crew
yeah.
going on over
right.
there. He had all this various artists kind of things.
Tony Starks. Yeah.
Plus, he created his own language.
He had his own language.
As much
that was
as
his
him,
own
and Ray, him and Ray kind of created this whole like.
Exactly.
Like, you know, I mean, all these different kind of vocabulary, man.
Yeah.
Fish scales,
right.
you know, like all this like. Pretty much the most randomest stuff ever.
He took over what Grand Poobah used to do.
Oh, yeah.
Grand Poobah always was the innovator of doing things before anybody else, saying
right.
things, wearing things.
Right.
Ghostface was the equivalent
yeah.
of that in current
Ghostface
age.
Is probably the reason why I bought a pair of Wallabies.
There you go.
Wallaby champ.
That's right.
They're one of the big reasons. I mean, East Coast, everybody probably wore Wallabies. But he was the
yeah.
one that kind of brought it to the forefront for us.
Yeah.
People in Hawaii.
Right.
Like who, you guys know, people out there, you guys know what Clarks are? That's like old man shoes.
Yep, those old man shoes, yes.
For a hip hop fan, well, that's the thing about hip hop in the 90s. They embraced Dickies, which is workwear.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Carhartt, workwear.
Carhartt.
You know what I mean? Polo, Nautica,
yeah.
you'll figure, white yuppie wear.
Right.
And Clarks.
That was one of the
old
one of the
man
things,
shoes.
One of the great things of hip hop, how
yeah.
it just takes things that nobody sees coming and then makes it their own.
Yeah.
It makes it their own little cool hip thing.
So I'm down with Ghostface too.
That's right, Cherchez La Ghost. That was one of his biggest songs.
What is
Tommy Mato,
yeah,
that song.
That song is dope.
What the heck? And then who's in that? Who's that song? Who's in that song with him? Who's
I hear
in
it.
That song? Who he really never got his just due. I would like to interview him just to find out like what does he think of his reflection on his career?
Oh god.
He's on that song.
I'm stuck.
You got son.
You got it.
What in the head, I'm fed. This is how but a rough ride.
Was it RZA or Mathematics, was it?
I always want to say it's Mathematics because that's the only guy I know.
Yeah,
who did
that
song? Let's put it
is RZA capable of doing that kind of beat?
I don't think.
Because that was definitely the snares weren't hitting in that one.
Yes.
Until I had that little breakdown.
Yes.
You know? But it's pretty genius.
It's a excellent jam.
It's a jam. You can play that. Yeah. Is that a club banger right there?
That's a club banger.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
Who do you think the producer is? Is it?
K. Okay, let's see here. It's from Supreme Clientele.
Yes.
And the song is produced by, we have it pulled up here.
Go, bro.
Tommy McToto lives on the road. Produced, featured, you God does not show the producer.
Who produced it?
Secret question. I know people are at home.
I know all you Wu heads are like, come on, y'all.
Yeah, like, come on, bruh.
Bruh, you guys don't know. You guys ain't Wu-Tang fans.
I mean, come on. You guys ain't real, bruh. Keep it real. Let's just look up and Google it this
There's
way.
There's got to be somebody out there that just said it instantly.
Right?
In the internet world.
Producer, Carlos Bess.
Are you serious?
Yeah, producer, Carlos Bess.
Wow.
Devon Bess's brother, Carlos Bess.
Older brother from New York.
Wow.
Sent his younger brother to Hawaii.
Carlos
Bess. And sent him to Cleveland,
yeah.
Where he went crazy.
That's right.
In the airport.
2000, that song came out.
Hey, that's pretty good. It hit, you know, that's what I mean. We talk about Ghostface hitting that millennium.
And I tell you this right
still
now.
Still being relevant.
Here's Hawaii hip hop relevancy for clubbing. First person to play that song out.
Oh, here we go.
In the club. Was at Nick's Fish Market.
Oh, brah.
Nick's Fish Market. On Kohio Ave.
Oh, here we go.
DJ Drama.
Wow.
DJ Drama. I was there. Me and the man known as DJ Del. We were there.
DJ Del.
We were there, and at Nick's Fish Market Saturday nights was, let's just say, Fade to Black, right? Let's just say.
All right.
And the number one top heavy hitter to play the Fade to Black, that crowd music, DJ Drama, bro.
Wow.
And he had all the hits. All the hits. If you want to hear the hip hop, no frills, no Moax, none of this kind of howling rappers.
No jazz fudge, bro.
New York style. Hit him. Gangsta rap. Hit him. And he had Ghostface.
Wow.
Tommy McToto.
First time ever. Bro.
He played it because he gets promos before they come out.
Oh, okay.
So he played all this stuff before it came out because he was in millions of record pools.
Right.
You know, because plus he was an African American DJ. He gets all the records.
Yeah.
So therefore he was there, played. Shea Lagos.
There you go.
I was like, oh, what is this? Oh, bro, what's this? Oh, wait, it's Ghostface.
Wait, you guys didn't even know what it was yet.
No.
Oh.
He played it like in like December of 99.
Wow, it's a doo doo.
And
just came in.
And Tom was like, oh, wait a minute. Bro.
Wow.
Oh. Of course we gotta do the whole go up to Drama and be like, oh, wow. Oh, what's this, man? What's this? Hey, yo, man, you know what, man? It's a new Ghostface, man. Oh, bro.
He actually told you what it was.
He does. Nice, he tells us.
Nice.
Because he's not like...
Man, I had the labels, bro, back in the early 90s, bro.
He had all the white labels. Oh. That was a white label. He had it in the white label sleeve. And then after that, then you play Jay-Z, Diplomats, Camera.
Is that what he played
Perfect.
After?
Yeah.
Done already.
Oh,
the great club
stuff.
Is on fire.
The block is hot.
The block is hot.
I miss that kind of stuff.
Yeah, that was
like
that,
New York thug songs.
New York thug songs.
I mean, enough of this kind of like, let's be all like articulate and vasculate and ejaculate. Let's talk about like some thug stuff, man. Let's talk about
taking the streets.
You know
what it is? These rappers nowadays, they grew uteruses. Yeah. That's why, bro.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know how they did it, but that's what happened.
Yeah, they're dressing like Westbrook. Come on, guys.
Oh, bruh. Anyway.
So we got Method Man.
Method Man.
Oh, Dirty Bastard.
At Ghostface.
Ghostface,
okay. Say, okay, this one it keep you up in the air, because there's members to be had in Wu-Tang. There's RZA, there's the GZA.
Yes.
There's also Raekwon.
Yeah.
You could go Master Killer, you could go Capadonna. You could go
Milk This Cow.
I'm gonna go. I think I'm gonna go because this is a hard one.
Right?
This is really hard. Do you have someone on top? Do you know?
I got somebody.
Okay, who? Say it.
RZA.
Oh, man.
It was a tough. It was between either GZA or RZA. They have one of the two have to be in there because they were the forefathers. You know,
yeah.
Raekwon's up there too. That'd be my nominees.
Right.
Because Raekwon, I mean, Cuban Link still to this day is such a great
it's
album.
Great.
I mean, sure, everything kind of didn't go quite well after.
Right.
Cuban Link is a six mic album.
I love Raekwon. Cuban Link's great album. All their first albums, great albums.
Yeah.
So you can't really rank them. I was going to go just because he don't get the love.
Here we go.
GZA.
Yeah. I like
that
it.
That first album was freaking
amazing. I like it. Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah.
From the samples.
Liquid Swords.
Liquid Thought. Right.
Okay, funny you mention that. Because, okay, you segue.
Look
so
at it, bro. What is going on, bro?
You win the award for segue of the decade.
Segue of the everything. That's
okay,
right.
So
we do
as you
a
can
podcast.
See, YouTube listeners.
All right, YouTube.
Viewers. I'm wearing a Wu-Tang shirt. I'm wearing the Light Sleepers Wu-Tang shirt here, okay?
Wu-Tang.
So I was thinking, Gavin was gonna wear the Wu-Tang shirt, okay? But I remember he was gonna wear the Earl Kai McKee shirt. Yeah, shout out to Earl Kai McKee.
Shout out Earl Kai.
So if he was wearing this shirt, I'm not gonna wear the same shirt with him, so right. I bought a backup shirt.
There you go.
And that backup shirt is this, okay? It is the Genius.
Oh, there you go.
Liquid Swords album, but it's actually a Chris Childs punching Kobe Bryant, okay? Take a look at this, everybody. Chris Childs getting punching up Kobe Bryant, which, you know, go figure, that's gonna cause a problem, viewers, but listen to that. I was gonna wear this shirt. This is the nice. Album cover. Two Liquid Swords, the Genius album, which is a phenomenal album.
That is a great album.
So, there you go. I have to say, you were exactly right.
Hey, there you go. So at least we got like RZA and GZA.
At least we got them out.
Raekwon is left out chilling.
Yeah.
You got crying.
Raekwon's on top of though.
Master Killer, he did one verse and was like, I'm out.
He's all right.
Peace out. The Capodanno drinking cappuccinos.
Of course he has to. The one guy who chopped his penis off, he's got other issues.
That's all the subgroups. Yeah. All those weird subgroups that they had.
No, we got
Sons of Man.
Sons of Man.
Any kind. Shaolin Warriors.
Gravediggers.
Gravediggers.
Shaheem, the Rugged Child.
We gotta give a
shout out to Shaheem, Rugged Child. That was a good album too.
Great album.
You know? What was we missing?
King Just, which was it from Wu-Tang?
King Just was
not. But he claimed Shaolin.
He thought he was.
UMC's.
That's right.
Second album.
Let's not forget UMC's.
They claimed Shaolin because they are from Staten.
Inspect the Deck.
Inspect the Deck.
We didn't talk about Inspect the Deck.
Well, you know what? His solo albums wasn't as good as, you know.
No. Very disappointing his album.
But lyrically, on point.
Inspector Deck, great guest appearances.
Great guest appearances.
You know, Above the Clouds.
But great.
Classic.
And the one with Pete Rock. Him.
True Master.
True Master.
With Corrupt.
Woo! That track has got to be one of the hottest.
Pete Rock, Corrupt, Inspector Deck.
Inspector Deck.
Great stuff.
Great.
What else we got?
I forgot Deck, man. I forgot Deck.
You got Master Killer, Capodanno, Raekwon. There's like a million of them. Who else we got? Who else we got?
Yeah, I mean, that's like
all them all, right? I mean, that's
kind of like the gist of it all. So yeah. We had Method Man, ODB. We had RZA and GZA for one.
Ghostface Killer.
And then we had Ghostface Killer and RZA.
That's it.
I mean, nobody's really wrong in this.
Yeah.
Unless you say Master Killer. I mean,
unless you put the guy who cut his penis off in there. If any of you guys put that guy who cuts penis off,
isn't his name like Hellraiser or something?
Something like that.
Oh, God.
Yeah, Switchblade Raisin.
Switchblade Maroni or something.
Switchblade
this
Maroni.
This is what you do. You Google it live. Wu-Tang member that lost his member.
He just cut it off because he was just fed up with society? What was the reason why he cut it off?
He was on drugs, I think. Yeah, same way why
drugs
his name blew out his eye.
Yeah. He called up Bushwick Bill. He said, Bushwick, what
should I do? I do this, bro.
You're like, all you gotta do is you cut it. Okay. That's how the conversation went. That's how it went, exactly.
Just cut him, boo.
What do I do? What is this guy's name?
Get the knife. You just kind of slice him, cuz. Here we go.
Slice him up, flip it, rub it down.
Wu-Tang member, Vienna sausage cutter. Look, the internet is frozen right
see?
Now.
There you go.
It will not let us find.
Okay, Wu-Tang member.
No, look, I'm really stuck.
Wu-Tang. Guy who cut penis.
That's exactly what I put. Wow. Wu-Tang member cut penis.
His name is
Hellraiser.
Hellraiser? Christ Bearer.
Christ Bearer.
Wait a minute, let's see. Let's get that confirmed. File to penises. Is
yeah,
right? Christ Bearer.
Yeah.
Andre Christ Bearer Johnson. How fitting, weird is that? Andre Johnson is his name.
Wow.
Not the wide receiver for Houston, Texas. Christ Bearer, the formerly Wu-Tang affiliated rapper who cut off his own penis and jumped off a second floor balcony last year, has finally given an explanation. PCP and meth, and Molly and alcohol, and
no
sleep.
No sleep, people.
PCP and meth and Molly and alcohol, and no sleep.
Equals no penis.
Clearly, he's not very good with grammar. That was the main thing. No sleep.
Yeah.
Effed up on several different drugs at the apartment of a famous friend he wouldn't name, Andre Johnson, wide receiver, Houston, Texas. I'm kidding. He got depressed because his three baby mamas, groupie ass bitches, as he puts quote unquote,
wow.
had all filed restraining orders and blocked his phone. Did you cut your penis off? They asked him, you know I did. I effed up in a lot of ways.
Yeah.
Wow. I don't really know if we should end the show at this point.
Cut there it out, bro. Cut it out. Let's end it on a better note. Wu-Tang. How many times have you seen Wu-Tang?
Twice.
Big Melon, were you there? Were you there for
World Cafe?
Yeah. Did they come down again? They did, right?
They came down for Blaisdell with Bone Thugs.
Yes.
What was that tour? that Rock the Bells tour.
Rock the Bells. I did not go to that.
I don't think anyone went to that. Oh. It was lame. Only had those two groups and Supernatural.
Oh.
Rock the Bell tour usually has like 20 groups.
Yeah.
But then for Hawaii, we only got Wu-Tang and Bone Thugs.
Nobody went.
That's like having Far Side and then Booyah Tribe same concert. Like, yeah, one group is going to go and then the other people leave.
Yeah.
And the other people, exactly. That's what you talked about. That's the same thing.
Yeah.
Two different factions and groups of fans. It's stupid.
I don't even know why people like Bone Thugs still.
I don't get it.
I never liked Bone Thugs.
I don't get it.
Now what a negative note.
We're going to end Wu-Tang show with, why do people like Bone Thugs? What is that about?
Sleep time's over. Captain the Cameras, DJ Zach Morris. Shout out to Michaela.
Yes.
Code of the Streets. Shout out to every Wu-Tang member. Big up to the Wu, the W's.
Shout out.
And then Tasha went like this. Boop. Made an H.
Well, you like the H, yeah. Boop. Boop. You like that. Like diversify your bonds.
There you go.
Right.
So shout out to Wu-Tang. If you don't know who Wu-Tang is, please listen to Wu-Tang.
Please.
Staten Island represent. That is a childhood that founded our childhood.
Shaped our life.
I don't know what that means or why we are this way, but let's blame it on Wu-Tang.
We thank them.
Make sure. Blame it on Wu-Tang.
There you go.
Sleep time's over. Captain the Catalyst, DJ Zach Morris, season 4, episode 4.
The Wu-Tang episode.
Wu-Tang, 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 Wu-Tang. Heavy sound effect.
There you go. Put them all up. That's right.
There you go. Exclusive extras right now on top of the YouTube. Make sure you guys let us know. We didn't even tell them to let us know what Wu-Tang members you like.
Oh, yeah. That's right. So, YouTube listeners. Viewers, whatever you want to call yourselves.
Yeah.
You know, you guys have been commenting really well, so just comment.
Thank you.
Comment on who you think is, you know, your favorite Wu-Tang memories, members, all that stuff. If you like the guy who cut his penis off, so be it.
Christ bearer.
You do you, brah, as they say.
Christ bearer.
Christ bearer. Man. Yes. PCP is a hell of a
PCP, cocaine, what are you, PCP, alcohol, mollies, and no sleep is a hell of a drug.
Yep, there you go. So be it. Thank you to everyone.
The scenes, bro.
Tired
episode
already.
4. Season 4. Episode 4.
Yes.
Somehow we've moved to 4 segments.
Yeah. Because we got this interview segment now that kind of throws things up.
Yeah, it's all good.
You know, all these people. Next week's going to be a big interview segment. Get ready. Make sure your computer don't crap out, bro. Big segment coming next week. Big interview.
Who is it? You big guest. This is exclusive right here.
Big guest. All you people listening. We're not letting the cat out of the bag, only to you. Chef Leanne Wong.
Wow.
Iron Chef, Top Chef.
Top Chef.
Top Chef, not Iron Chef. Top Chef,
top
Leanne
chef.
Wong. Coco Egg Cafe.
Yeah.
She's the one.
And supposedly she's a hip hop head.
And she's supposedly a hip hop head.
So we're gonna have double quiz for her.
Oh, get you ready for that one.
You hip hop, you coming to the Thunderdome.
That's right.
Double quiz.
Leanne Wong leaves, hopefully she can leave out.
Oh, Leanne Wong enters. Leanne Wong leaves!
There you go, bruh. So yeah, everyone out there, Leanne Wong.
Leanne Wong!
Not quite. But she's going to be doing the next hip-hop dinner at Cocoid Cafe. That's going to be in June. So...
Hey,
you guys are getting exclusive news here,
exclusive
right here.
Exclusive news right here.
So there you go.
What's some other exclusive news they can have since there's running time?
Alright. Coming also soon, Justin Park.
Yeah, there you go.
Bar Leather Apron.
Yeah.
You'll be a guest on here.
We tried to get, let's just put air it out here. DJ Compose.
DJ Compose can't amino.
He doesn't want to come over here, bruh.
Yeah,
he's scared of the truth, bruh.
He said he can't.
You sit
handle.
In this chair, it's the hot seat, it'll make you cry.
Rip this thing. Yes, everybody can cry.
Everybody can cry, internet, or you know, reflect on life.
Speaking of reflections and people crying, we're also going to have, maybe in the future, Jimmy Taco.
Yeah, Jimmy Taco.
We're also going to have
Super CW.
Super CW's coming.
You know?
What else we got?
What else we got? Hopefully, Nick Rolovich.
Hopefully Nick
Rolovich. He's been very busy. He actually responded and actually came to the shop second time. Say
that's
what's
right.
up.
That's
he's
right.
the most busiest coach. Bottom line, he's got a win-win-win.
Right.
And that should open a lot of floodgates once we get Rolo.
I hope so. We got to get him before the season, though, because he's going to be too busy.
True that.
We got to get him in the summer somehow.
Yeah.
You know? So that's going to come.
What else we got in?
We still trying to get Brother Marcus, but he's back in Nashville
Brother
already.
Marcus, brah. Gotta get some of these newscasters eventually.
We gotta get the newscasters. We still gotta get Mr. Neil Everett.
Neil Everett, brah. We need you, brother Neil.
That's right.
Give us a call. Hit me up.
That's right.
922-2222.
Yeah.
Then Frankie Lima can come pick you up.
You know, that's actually the number for the shirt in Waikiki.
Oh, 922?
922-4422 is the... My mom used to work for a shirt in Waikiki. So if you call that number, you're going to get guest services. So yeah.
That's it.
That's all I got.
You guys have a good one. Sleep time's over. Exclusives. After podcasts. Video exclusives. Don't forget, sleep time's over on everything except for Twitter. Sleep time's over.